off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Florida Atlantic is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. Tackle made at the 27-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Quick pass. Inside the 30. Tackle made at the 13-yard line.
Another impressive play. This offense can hurt you in a lot of different ways, and they're showing them off right here.
Throws a strike over the middle. What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial and a first down.
Touchdown, Jaguars.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
And he hits the PAT. Short three-play, 73-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown, saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
So the score now, 7-0. He's taken down at the 26-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. The stop around the 39-yard line.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
He makes it to the 42-yard line. He's on the run, decides to slide. Brought down at the 42. Taken down at the 32. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Pressure got to him and he put it on the ground. Offense falls on him.
And they're lucky to retain possession of the ball there.
Once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down. The Owls running back down there on the sideline. He was injured earlier. He means a lot to this offense, but I think he's going to be able to come back in. Looks like he's ready to go. And a quick throw.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
Yardage on that. They'll go with a run once again. He's pushed out of bounds at the 12. But he can't shake the defense. He's got it out to his tight end. He's tackled around the 2-yard line. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. It's fielded at the 2. Tackle at the 27. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football. It's over. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. And he misses his wide receiver there.
Yeah, you're right. This is an area that he's worked so hard to improve since day one, the accuracy of his throws. He's improved, but as you can see, he's upset here with himself.
Here's the halfback. And down he goes, right around the 40. Nice game for the halfback.
That time they kept it on the ground with the counterplay. The blocking was great up front, and the tailback was able to get into the open field and do some special things. This quarterback has got to do a better job of looking off defenders and allow his covered receivers some room to improvise and get free.
From their own 40-yard line, second down. Go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. Tackle at the 39-yard line.
That makes it 3rd and 11.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He gets hit out of bounds at the 46. Fires out to his wide out, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 48. From the 48-yard line, it's second down. It to the tight end, and he's taken down at the 38. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, this is a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
Nice run up the middle. He's tackled at the 30-yard line.
Tight end.
zips it to the back. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 22-yard line. Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start. Offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
So we'll have first and 15 after the penalty. And they hit him in the backfield.
He's really quick with his lateral movement. Especially for a guy this big. He got to the ball carrier before he could get out of the backfield.
We're at the 12th play of the drive. So at the end of one quarter, we get a tie game at 7-7. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we're dead even. Complete. They'll bring him down around the 17-yard line. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
Tackle made at the 10-yard line.
Safeties playing up close to the line of scrimmage, almost like a fourth linebacker. The only way that you can keep them from cheating up is to take some chances downfield.
This is play number 15 of a very impressive drive. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. And that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
So again, a third down as the offense lines up. Gets rid of it quickly. Oh, what an interception.
The defense really cranked up the heat there. Give those guys all the credit for forcing a desperation pass.
Third and five situation. Ball on the 25. He's tackled in the open field.
Snap count perfectly. He found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
They come up to the line here. It's second down and 14 after the sack. Pressure. And he's hit immediately.
I'm sure the coaches are going to tell him to calm down and be more careful, because I guarantee you, nobody keeps throwing those passes into the defense like that without making a mistake.
They'll run it inside and tackle quickly.
That makes it
He's got room to work. He goes out of bounds around the 48-yard line. And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. And here's the, wait a minute, the upback's got it. He's tackled at the 48-yard line. Defense stiffens on fourth down, and the ball will change hands. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Slings it. And they make the stop at the 35. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. He fights forward to about the 30. Here's a run. He makes it to the 28-yard line. It's fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. South Alabama could take the lead with this field goal. Might have been some early movement up front.
False start.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a five-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Quick throw to the tight end. He's to the 40. He's knocked out of bounds around the 45-yard line. Their own 45-yard line. First down. Crosses out to the tailback on the screen. He's at the 40. And they push him out around the 33-yard line. From the 33-yard line, first down. Throws and it's incomplete. That makes it second and 10. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Fires incomplete, knocked away.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid, fundamental pass defense.
Third down, and they need to get 23. Runs set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. He's pushed out of bounds around the 23-yard line. Still completed it. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
Here's the true test of a quarterback at any level. Can they make a good throw under pressure when one or two or three guys are coming right at him? I think this young passer has proven that, yes, he can.
And he tackles him hard at the one-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback. This is the eighth play of this drive. The Owls use their second timeout. Touchdown, Owls.
That was a very good all-around effort. The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
He makes the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He'll take it from the two. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Caught, open field. Brought down at about the 33-yard line. South Alabama just took their first time out. First and 10. Ball on the 33. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete. Complete. He's got room. He steps out at the 35-yard line. From their own 35-yard line. It's third down. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He's taken down around the 40-yard line. About 5 yards on the screen. The Owls using their third and final timeout. Gets to about the 37-yard line. Six points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe it's a little bit more pressure, and they might be able to force him into a mistake.
Florida Atlantic is upsetting. Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. So at the end of the half, Owls lead 14-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. I love this first half. Two defenses that will flat stick their face in the fan. I mean, there was some hitting going on out there. Good, clean, tough football in the first half. Much like you experienced, David, there was almost a magic number for your teams at Georgia. If you got to a certain number of points, the game was over.
Yeah, I was there for my 4 years, when our team scored over 17 points, we were undefeated. So when you have a great defense, first of all, you have high expectations. You expect to come in and shut the opponent out. And the offense on the other side, you know what you got too. You don't have to go out there and try to fling it around the yard and score 30 points a game. You don't have to put a lot on yourself. You just execute the plays that are in front of you and realize that punts aren't going to kill you. I got a dominant side of the football. Play towards that strength. don't shoot myself on the foot on the other side of the football.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. A kick. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Florida Atlantic is up a score. Passes in and it's picked off by the safety. And down he goes at the 21-yard line.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. Quick strike to the back, no good. Defense has been in this situation before. They forced a huge turnover when they were backed into their own red zone last time. And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
It's fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. It's up, and it sails through the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Taken from the 3-yard line. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time, throwing a pick on their last drive.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
Nice run there. Florida Atlantic is up by 4. At about the 45. With the pass incomplete. They need to get it down to the 36. And he's tackled right around the 44-yard line. That's a The Owls wide down there on the sideline. Looks like he's warming up. Good to see that he might be able to get back in this game. Right now, he wants to get this kick away and change field position. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he shoved out of bounds at about the 29-yard line. There's a strike complete. Tackle made at the 36. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Fires quick, he catches another, and they get him in the backfield for a loss. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39. He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away. Florida Atlantic holds a four-point lead. Now he's brought down in the open field. Zips it to the tight end. He's out to the 30, and he's level at the 33. They'll bring him down at the 31-yard line. Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 31. Quick strike to the receiver. Knocked out of bounds around the 39. And he throws it away, and that'll make it fourth down.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
At the 29-yard line.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
No chance.
Still first down.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. Throws it out, and it falls incomplete.
Second and 10.
He's on the run. And they make the stop around the 49-yard line. Picks up five on the scramble. So at the end of three, the Owls lead 14-10. Great three quarters of action, tight ball game, and now it's the fourth quarter, and this will decide it. Over the middle to his tailback. And he's taken down around the 42-yard line. To about the 39. And they'll bring him down behind the line. That makes it unnecessary. To around the 32.
That makes it first and 10.
That's a great tackle at the 18-yard line. Quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. What a play, and that is first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
He's under some heat. Touchdown! And that puts them on top. Trying to go up by three. They'll kick the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. A 10-play, 57-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Brought down at the 26-yard line.
This has been a fun game to watch, going back and forth and back and forth. It's almost like watching a tennis match here. Whoever has the ball last, my guess, will be the team that wins it.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. And he hits him hard at the 41. Hit and taken down. Gets it to his tight end for a first down. They try to get a head start there.
False start. Offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still first down.
So the penalty will make it first and 15. This one's going deep to the end zone. Incomplete. Almost picked off. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five wide set. Scrambling around. Locked down at the 21.
Well, they didn't pick up the first down, but he saw that no one was open, so he made the right decision to tuck it and run.
Just under three to go in regulation. Caught out of the open. He's taken down. The 12. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Out of bounds, right around the 6-yard line. Come out in a five wide set. Now he tries to buy some time. And down he goes at the three. He's in. Touchdown. Take the lead.
I think the option down by the goal line is a great call. It puts so much pressure on the defense and allows the quarterback to have the decision to run it or pitch it. And this time it worked to perfection.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. An 11-play, 79-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The score now, 21. Tackle made at 28. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Fires out to his wideout. He's tackled at about the 41. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Man, oh, what a hit. Under pressure, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. That makes it 3rd and 11. Third down, they need to get it inside the 49. A tremendous job by that defense, and their coordinator did a super job there to keep it this close in this ball game. And now the offense has got a chance to win it.
Here we go.
Throws it. Caught the 10. Touchdown, and they take the lead. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. Looks like they didn't get the playoff quick enough. South Alabama with a two-point advantage. And he hits the PAT. A nice five-play, 72-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback receivers getting in sync, making it for the defense to slow him down.
From his own goal line, he's to the 20, tries to get around the corner, and he's tackled at the 28-yard line.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer, and that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
Well, this sets up the drama here in the fourth quarter. They've got the opportunity they've been looking for, an opportunity to take the lead and the win. He's got to throw it in a hurry. Fired quickly, and he's got his man. Tackle around the 37.
Catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
He's under some heat. He's scrambling. Tackle made around the 22-yard line.
I doubt anybody will ever mistake this guy for a tailback, but he didn't look too bad ball there.
From the 22-yard line, first down. He brings it. To score here that late in the fourth quarter and come from behind. And now the question is, can their defense dig in and win it for them? And he converts the point. A four-play, 73-yard drive. They get it in for seven.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
And he's taken down at the 26. There are some tired defenders out there right now the way these offenses are playing.
Well, they just can't keep up. They're not only putting points on the board, they're doing it in a way that the defenses are back on their heels, hands on their hips. They are tired.
Here we are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? We'll see who's got the leadership. Goes to the tight end and knocked away. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 26. Under a minute left. Throws a bullet over the middle. They'll bring him down to 37-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.